Hello everyone, Father Leo here with PlatingGrace.com. Happy Feast of Christ, King of the Universe, as well as a Thanksgiving week and celebration to come. I want to just offer some thoughts about the Feast of Christ the King as it relates to our life here and now. We don't, at least in the United States, we don't have a king, but we do have forces that govern us and in a way lead us. And we always have to ask ourselves, especially if we aren't born in a kingdom, so to speak, how do you have a king? Because Christ wants to be the king of our souls, and we almost have rights to allow him in or to not. Or we can consider heaven as a kingdom. So how do you get a king like Jesus? Number one, you kind of have to be born in the kingdom. You're kind of like a natural citizen because you are born under the patronage of that king. And when you are baptized, you are automatically part of God's kingdom. A second way that you get a king is if you submit yourself to that king's authority. It's a type of an immigration. I want to enter into a relationship with a country or a kingdom, and therefore I have to submit myself to that country or that kingdom's rules and regulations. You basically hand over what you were to what you want to become. And so if you want to get into the kingdom of heaven and have Christ as the king of your heart and soul, then you give up the reign of sin, the tyranny of relativism, and all that is contrary to God, and you take on the life of a saint. And the third way that Christ can become your king is, like any king used to do back in the day, conquer you. And I know that that might sound frightening, but Christ doesn't come with violence, but with virtue. He doesn't come with war and weaponry. He becomes with the sacred word of God. And so sometimes we find ourselves in a little bit of a wrestling match with God. I got to let you know, you might put up a good fight, but nothing will overcome the goodness, the glory, and the power of God. So in a sense, you can just give up. But he will eventually conquer even sin and death in you if we but realize that he is not only the king of the universe, but he wants to start that kingdom in your heart, your mind, and your soul. So allow the Feast of Christ the King to give you a reason to be grateful. And so in this season of giving thanks, as we kind of prepare for Advent and obviously for Christmas, we want to make sure that we recognize that when you are charitable to other people, you are letting the kingdom of God be a manifest part of your life and of your soul. We have some very special things that are going to be coming up in Christmas, as well as obviously in Advent. We are going to be showing you eventually a little video of how you can be a part of this mission and this movement of our Plating Grace and Grub food truck, which not only helps people coming out of the prison system, but we're going to be dedicating the month of December and January to giving food to the poor and people in need, because this is a cold time of the year, at least in our part of the world where the truck operates. So we want to make sure that we are bringing a little bit of God's kingdom and goodness to those who don't feel like they are part of any family, really. And so we want to help, and you can be a part of that help. So stay tuned for Giving Tuesday, because we definitely need your help. And so we're going to be starting a campaign to get us through these next 2 months of giving back, and we can only give what we receive. And so we know that God is giving us a lot of graces, and we have that in our midst. May we share that generously with those in need. And so again, on this Feast of Christ the King of the Universe and in this season of giving thanks, I am saying a prayer for all of you. Thank you for listening, and stay hungry for God.